different sets, what they will do out of those sets. He said, second, after the read, we're disguising our coverages. We're giving Kelly and those guys plenty of problems trying to figure out what we're going to do. And then we're playing hard and getting to the ball. I talked to David Treadwell, the kicker. He says, I'm just going to keep on kicking. I hit the ball. The wind moved it.
A little play action pass from Kelly, and they're doing a pretty good job disrupting them right now.
All right, on the other hand, somebody could say, look, Buffalo comes in here an 11.5 point favorite. Denver gets some opportunities. Cragen made the great interception. They get three makeable field goals. Reasonable to assume they could have made two of those three. They could be up 6-0, maybe 9-0. Do those blown opportunities count you when you're this big of an underdog?
Well, can't see.
They might wind up holding Denver, but I have to give credit to Buffalo's defense, too. Denver's had tremendous field position the whole first half, and Buffalo, somehow or another, has been able to hold them out of the end zone. So Buffalo's defense is surviving pretty well also.
Before the first two missed kicks, there were sacks, one by Wright and one by Smith. They didn't take Denver out of field goal range, but they did make the field goal attempts by Treadwell longer.
No, but he had plenty of distance. He just missed the kick, hit the pole a couple of times. But Buffalo's got to feel pretty good about their chances, too.
All right, now up next, as we continue at halftime from Buffalo, we'll show you just how we settle the score in our season-long upset special selections. Will McDonough gets to live the good life as we come back after this.
Hi, Mom.
I'm Evan.
American drug agents landed in Colombia.
Can't
they
see.
Had one mission,
to take
out the world's most powerful cocaine cartel. This is the story of their war and their victory. Drug Wars, the cocaine cartel on NBC next Sunday.